With traditional flint and steel, there's not a lot of tinders that are really going to be able to catch a spark when you find out in the woods. Usually there's chaga, there's a few others, but a lot of times they have to be dried and processed. This, however, is a milkweed ovum. Actually, it's a milkweed pod. The ovum's right there. The ovum holds the seeds. This fluff, it's also a useful resource. It's a flashover tinder. I bet it would char good too. But today we're working on the ovum. This ovum, it can usually be picked and used right away. Look at this, seeds blowing away. But a lot of times it can be picked, used. Gives you one of your few shots of actually having. Some people also use it for a fire piston, but I've never done that. So here's how you use the ovum if you want to use it for carbon steel on quartz or chert or flint. I tear it in half, like that. I take a half. You can also position both of them using two fingers. Give that a try. Gives me double shot at making it. There we go. It's also a little harder to control. So we've got two pieces right on the edge of the rock. If this gets a little harder to control, I'll use just one. It's very windy today, so that might complicate things a bit. And I want to try to drive a spark into that fluffy area. It may take a little bit. It's not as easy as and that, of course, is ice falling from a tree. It's not as easy as chaga or charred materials, but it'll work. There we go. It's burning. Now this, naturally, you'd want, you want to have another tinder ready to go. You don't have a lot of time, especially with a small ovum like that. But if you had more ovums in a tinder bundle, punk wood, some chaga to help as a coal extender. That was it. So there you have it. Milkweed, and this milkweed, I picked this, I'd say a week ago, but I also used pods picked that day from the same area, and it rained earlier, and it's still, or still able to go, just 5 hours after picking it in the rain. Have to keep in mind, and the reason for that, very often, the ovum is protected by this pod. Acts as a little umbrella, and the ovum itself is very delicate and lightweight. Here's something interesting too. This one is a fresher one, just like that, the one I used. This one was sitting in the pod a little longer, turns brown. They both work. So even if they're like nice and yellow, or if they've been brown with a little age, they're both going to catch a spark. And thanks for watching. That's milkweed ovum with carbon steel.